Hey there, everyone, especially Tool fans. This is Andrew and Nick coming at you with another One Tribe production reaction video. We have officially completed our Tool discography. So with that, a lot of hours spent on that. We wanted to start doing something a little more fun. So we're going to take a couple of our commenters' advice, and we're going to look at some of these live concert works. Starting with the early 90s, we figured no better place to start than with the Opiate album. And so this is going to be a live jerk off from, well, Nick, why don't you tell me? You went ahead and pulled the video up for us. Go ahead.
Yeah. In fact, let me just kind of call out to a number of the people who have commented for us, starting with Triginta Tres, who says, I don't know why you aren't doing more live concert stuff. And you made a great suggestion that maybe we could kind of go chronologically and see kind of the progression of their performances. And you know, right after that, who else was there? Where was Scott Heslin was telling us, you two have to react to the 1998 Lalapalooza soundboard version of Jerk Off, which is exactly what we plan to do today. The public have spoken. I was a little sad that we were coming to the end of the journey, but you know, it doesn't have to be the end. There's so much more material to look at, and now we can actually see Tool more than just hear them, and I'm quite excited.
Yeah, and you should be in for quite a treat here. You know, it's one thing to listen to the lyrics. It's one thing for us to analyze, you know, deeper meanings. But it's another thing to see just the showmanship. I'm sure you remember from the Lollapalooza show, Maynard in the pink onesie, and it looks like he's basically just emotionally ripping through his own skin during that video. So sure we're in for a major treat with this one. I personally don't think I've ever seen this video, so it should be a treat for me as well, and we'll discuss Jerk Off a little bit more on the other side, but that's pretty much all we got for the front half of this, so let's jump right in and try to enjoy it.
Let's do it. Here we go. 1998 Lalapalooza soundboard version of Jerk Off. we'll talk about that. I think somebody's excited to hear them or see them.
Yeah. I always fangirl out at the shows too. It's just such an experience.
All right, here's the band going out, sitting down. Who knows how many songs into the set this is? Maybe they needed a break to, you know.
Yeah, and they do that. They take an intermission, or at least I know recently they do a full intermission where they leave the stage and come back. So the shows are long, and they extend their version.
Maynard's giving us a little bestiality with his inflatable pig. That's nice. Oh, he's tossing the pig to the audience. You're gonna love that.
That's a souvenir.
Oh man, imagine how much I would go for on eBay.
As long as it's still stained. Yeah.
What cup size do you think that bra is?
At least a D.
Yeah.
Covers whole face.
We don't normally do this song because people misinterpret it, and rightly so. See, there's a difference between hate and anger. Anger is constructive emotion. Hatred is not. It's destructive. And rather than acting out on the violence, instead, we scream our heads off and play loud music. That way, nobody gets hurt. So keep that in mind when we play this song. That it's not about fucking somebody up. It's about being very angry to the point where you have to scream about it rather than do something about it.
Good advice.
Very responsible of him as an artist to spread that message.
Now, don't go out and burn some cars. Just scream about it until you feel better.
Here he is, putting in the stance.
Yeah.
Thank you. Good night.
It's just electric. You feel it.
This is bottle to the ground. I'm so tempted to keep on watching and keep on listening to the next song.
Yeah, maybe we'll have to do an extended video where we watch like a portion of a concert where we can get a couple of songs in there. Because, yeah, as you could tell, he talks to the audience and they improvise quite a bit. But, I mean, the feeling is just electric. It's more than just the pageantry of the costumes. It's they are out there. Each performance seems like a one-time-only performance. They put together a set, they add stuff into it, and it's not the same the next night at the next show. It's beautiful.
Well, again, yeah, we're seeing this was 1998, so this is what? When the sober...
6 or 7 years after that.
I mean, there is
that,
definitely a quantum leap here in the performance. I mean, okay, the time of day is completely different. They've got the benefit of nighttime, so they can go crazy with lights. They can do some different things that way, but
they've got a little bit more creative freedom too, because now they're not just trying to make it. Now they're at a point where they're actively fighting with the record company because they're proving that they're a force to be reckoned with. So a lot more creative control when it comes to the show experiences.
Wow, that's all I've got to say as well.
Chills.
This song is the song we talked about it earlier this week. The one thing I wanted to talk about was he makes this hand gesture to the to the audience, and he doesn't do it like this. He gives it to it like this, right? And Spock from Star Trek, Leonard Nimoy.
It's an open palm.
Yeah.
But right.
He was Jewish.
And, oh, yeah. Leonard Nimoy. Yeah.
Also, you know, William Shatner. He still is Jewish. And and so as he's making up these things about the culture of Spock, he took this hand gesture from a part of the liturgical service. The liturgical service, the prayers, the morning prayers, when the Kohanim, the priests, come to the front of the congregation and they bestow the priestly blessing upon the congregation. Now, this can only happen if there are at least 10 men present and one of them is a priest. And to be a priest, a Kohen, means that this person is supposed to be descended from Aaron, the brother of Moses, who was the first high priest, right? And they make hand gesture underneath. They're covered by their prayer shawls, so they become anonymous. You don't see them, but underneath their prayer shawls, they're making this hand gesture, right? And this is where it comes from originally. And so he's kind of in front of his congregation, giving them the blessing before the message. You know, it's very cool.
Wow. Yeah, it's really interesting to hear that, because it brings back all those memories I have of Reverend Maynard, and, you know, the few times I have seen them live. He does it. I wouldn't say it's like he's preaching to the crowd, but he definitely comes out and has something to say. He wants to involve us with what's going on. So for him to start his show or start this song with that gesture and then inform everybody that, listen, I think you guys are getting this song a little wrong. It's not necessarily about wants and destruction out of anger. It's about taking that anger and then choosing to have it be your driving force, interchange.
Anger's okay. Do something about it. Hatred is only going to destroy things and yourself. Yeah. And what's also interesting is the juxtaposition between the sacred and the profane. Right, because he's making a sacred hand gesture, and he's a bald guy wearing a bra, and he's got this culture clash going on. He's trying he's trying to open doors. He's not doing it to I don't think he's doing it to be controversial. No. I think he's doing it to break down mental barriers, you know, and I think in the end, very cool performance. Very, very, yeah. I don't have anything else to say.
One thing I did want to bring up is that, you know, this isn't the first live version we've listened to,
no.
But one thing that I'm a firm believer on, and I'm sure a lot of Tool fans are believers in, is that these guys care so much about their live performances that the sound quality is really there. You're still able to hear every member of the band. With a lot of other bands, it's turn everybody down, turn the singer way up. It doesn't matter what it sounds like. They're here to hear the hits.
Yeah.
With Tool, that's not going on. Maynard is middle in the mix. He's right there with everybody. Everything sounds crisp and clear. Even those crazy squeals we get from Adam's guitar are clear. You can hear each note coming in rather than just a wall of distortion. So definitely something that we'll see more of as we progress. We'll go ahead and do something, maybe a couple somethings off the Anima album, off the Undertow album, Undertow, then Anima. And then, we'll just move forward and unfortunately, that means y'all are probably going to have to wait a little bit longer for Numa Live because we're going to hit some other albums first. With that, do you have anything else you'd like to add about, the Opiate album, Tool in general, live performances?
No. I'd really like to have one of our subscribers, somebody who really is enthusiastic about the Opiate album to come on with us and talk to us about it because there is so much to talk about.
Yeah, we need somebody in their late 30s, early 40s, maybe even older. If Opiate was yours growing up, if this was what you listened to every day and you got something to say about it, please reach out to us. We'd love to have you on. We'd love to discuss with another member of the Tool Army if possible. So that'd be great.
All right.
Yeah. Thanks so much for watching. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you haven't already. Tune in to any of our previous works we've done. If you've got a favorite Tool song, we've reacted to it at this point. We'd love to have you back next time. Until then, see you again.
Peace, love.